My most memorable moment from my time in the Nobel Committee is from the Nobel Prize in 2008, and more specifically for the Nobel lecture by one of the laureates, Osamu Shimomura. He opened his Nobel lecture telling us one day in August 1945, during the Second World War, he had been standing outside his family home near Nagasaki, and he had seen the American bombers in the sky like any other day, except this day was different because it was not an ordinary bomb that was dropped, but it was an atomic bomb. And so he saw the atomic bomb blast. He felt the pressure wave, but he was sufficiently far away not to get badly hurt. And then he said, a couple of years later, when he had finished high school and had to go into university, he looked into Nagasaki University and he realized that there was only one building left, and that was the Department of Pharmacology. So he said, therefore, I had to study pharmacology. And this eventually led him to the work that awarded him the Nobel Prize in 2008. I am Gunnar von Heijne. I'm a professor in the Department of Biochemistry and Biophysics at Stockholm University. And I've served a total of 19 years on the Nobel Committee for Chemistry, both as a member, chair, and secretary. My first contact with the Nobel Committee for Chemistry was a phone call out of the blue from an older colleague who said, Gunnar, I have an offer you cannot refuse. We want you on the Nobel Committee for Chemistry. To be honest, I hadn't really thought much about the Nobel Committee for Chemistry before that time, and I didn't really know what to expect. But looking back now, I can say that there is no other job that I've had that has been so interesting and so much fun as serving on the Nobel Committee. I was told when I started in the committee that the only acceptable reason for not coming to a meeting is your own funeral. But apart from that, I've never seen anybody not come to a meeting during these 19 years. And then you should know that the committee meets 10 times a year or something. So we're talking 200 meetings, and everybody has shown up at every meeting. In 2002, I believe it was, Kurt Wüthrich, a Swiss scientist, received the Nobel Prize in Chemistry. But it took a little bit of time to actually get him the news, because when the famous phone call was made from the Royal Swedish Academy of Sciences, and the person at the end of the line answered, and the secretary of the academy said, is this Professor Kurt Wüthrich? The person at the other end said, yeah, here's Kurt Wüthrich, in German. And although we had asked a question in English, and that made us a little bit wary. So we asked again, is this Professor Kurt Wüthrich? Yeah, here's Kurt Wüthrich, was the answer. Turned out we had not reached Professor Kurt Wüthrich at the ETH in Zurich, but we had reached Kurt Wüthrich, the ambulance driver in Zurich. At the end of the day, it turned out to be a nice story, because the two Kurts actually met and had coffee together, and I think struck up a friendship. So maybe it wasn't such a bad mistake after all. We tried to identify breakthroughs in chemistry that could potentially become Nobel Prizes. And we tried to figure out who are the scientists responsible for these breakthroughs. Who are the key persons behind a discovery or an improvement? And we do this by going through huge numbers of nominations that we receive every year. We ask experts around the world to give us their opinions and evaluations about particular prize areas. And we discuss a lot inside the committee about whether one area or another is more ripe for a Nobel Prize, and who, if we do award a prize, who the actual laureates should be. Sometimes it requires a bit of detective work. to figure out what really went on in a lab at critical time 20 years ago, and generally weigh the contributions of different people against each other to come up with a final recommendation as to who should be included in a particular prize. That is probably the most tasking job that we have in the committee. What I'm most satisfied about is that we haven't made any major blunders as far as we know. Some very exciting prizes that we've been involved with, and generally speaking, have been able to carry the baton further to the next generation of people on the committee.